Hi everyone. In this video, we are going to discuss about example of root locus. The given example is sketch the root locus of the system whose open loop transfer function is g of s is equal to k by s into s plus 2 s plus 4. So this is the given example. Here in this example, the open loop transfer function is k by s into s plus 2 into s plus 3. Sketch the root locus of the given open loop transfer function. Now coming to the solution. Step 1. To locate the poles and zeros, first locate the open loop poles and zeros in ordinary graph sheet. So first calculate poles and zeros of the given transfer function. So given that the open loop transfer function g of s is equal k divided by s into s plus 2 into s plus 4. So first find out the zeros and poles of the given transfer function. Zeros are located in the numerator and poles are located in denominator. So in this open loop transfer function, there is no zeros. And there are three poles. Given that there are three poles. And the poles are at s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4. The poles are s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4 are the poles of the given transfer function. And step 1. Locate poles and zeros. In an ordinary graph sheet. So now here the poles are s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4 and zeros are zeros. There is no zeros. So take the ordinary graph sheet, and this is the ordinary graph sheet. In this ordinary graph sheet, x-axis is the real axis and y-axis is the imaginary axis. S is equal to sigma plus j omega, the Laplace transform plane. S is equal to sigma plus j omega, and x is the real part of s and y-axis is the imaginary part of s, and s is equal to sigma plus j omega, and this is the real axis or x-axis, that is sigma, and this is y-axis or the imaginary axis. And first consider the scale, and s is equal to, and this is the origin, so consider the scale first, 0, minus 1, this is negative real axis, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like that. And the positive x-axis, plus 1, plus 2, like that. So now here this scale, on x-axis 18 is equal scale. On x-axis, 1 unit is equal to 0.5 centimeters. And similarly, consider the scale on y-axis. And this is positive y-axis and this is negative y-axis. And y-axis is j omega axis and this is plus j1, j2, j3, J3, J4, like that. And negative imaginary axis, negative y-axis. So minus J1, minus J1, minus J2, minus J3, minus J4. On y-axis, 1 unit is equal to 0.5. And y-axis is also 1 unit is equal to 0.5 centimeters. First, locate the poles and zeros in an ordinary graph sheet. Now here, what are the zeros from the given transfer function? There is no zeros. And the poles are s is equal to 0, s is equal to minus 2, and s is equal to minus 4. So the zeros are indicated by small circle and poles are indicated by small cross mark. Now here the poles are at s is equal to 0. At s is equal to 0 is one pole. The poles are indicated by small cross mark. And another pole is at s is equal to minus 2. That is indicated by small cross mark. And another pole is at s is equal to minus 4. Represent the poles and zeros in an ordinary graph sheet. The zeros are represented by small circle and poles are represented by small cross mark. And second step, step 2. And step 2 is find out the root locus branches to determine root locus on real axis. To find root locus on real axis. To find the root locus on real axis. And this is second step. Now here there are three poles on the real axis. There are three poles on the real axis. Choose a test point on the real axis between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 pole. Consider a test point between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2. And this is the test point. Consider the test point here. To the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros is 1. So, total number of poles and zeros is 1, and which is an odd number. Hence, the real axis between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 will be a part of the root locus. Once again, I will explain the same concept. So, find out the root locus on the real axis. How to calculate the root locus on the real axis? Consider now here on the real axis, the total number of poles are 3. First, consider the test point between s is equal to 0 pole and s is equal to minus 2 pole. And this is s is equal to 0 pole and this is s is equal to minus 2 pole. Consider the test point between s is equal to 0 pole and s is equal to minus 2 pole. So this is our test point and this is our test point. To the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros. To the right of this test point, total number of poles and zeros are 1. That 1 is an odd number. 1 is an odd number. Hence, the real axis between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 will be a part of the root locus. Will be a part of the root locus. So between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 1 will be a part of the root locus. Highlight the root locus. Between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 is a part of the root locus. Highlight that root locus. And applying the same procedure. And this is s is equal to minus 2 pole and s is equal to minus 4 pole. Consider the test point between s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4. Now we are considering the test point. This is my test point. Okay. So to the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros. So to the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros are 2. and this is one pole and this is another pole. To the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros are 2, which is an even number, which is an even number. To the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros is a 2, which is an even number. Hence, the real axis between s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4 is not a part of the root locus. Next, consider the test point to the left of s is equal to minus 4. And what is this negative real axis scale? Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, like that up to minus infinity. Next, to consider the test point between s is equal to minus 4 and s is equal to minus infinity. Or consider the test point between to the left of s is equal to minus 4th pole. So now here I am considering the test point and this is my test point. To the right of this test point, count the total number of poles and zeros. To the right of this test point, total number of poles and zeros are 3. And this is one pole and this is another pole, this is another pole. So to the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros are 3. And 3 is an odd number. So to the left of s is equal to minus 4 will be a part of the root locus. Highlight the root locus on the real axis. And this is the part of the root locus. To the left of s is equal to minus 4. Is a part of the root locus. And these are the root locus branches on the real axis. And this is the first root locus branch and this is the second root locus branch. Once again, I will explain the same concept. Listen carefully. So now here on the root locus, the total number of poles and zeros are 3. First, consider the test point. Between s is equal to 0 pole and s is equal to minus 2 pole. And this is my test point. Consider the test point at this point. To the right of this test point, total number of poles and zeros are 1, which is an odd number. So between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 will be a part of the root locus. Highlight the root locus on the real axis. And now consider the test point between s is equal to minus 2 pole and s is equal to minus 4 pole. And this is my test point. To the right of this test point, the total number of poles and zeros are 2, which is an even number. So between s is equal to minus 2 and s is equal to minus 4 will not be a part of the root locus. Next, consider the test point between s is equal to minus 4 and s is equal to minus infinity, or consider the test point to the left of s is equal to minus 4. And this is the left of the s is equal to minus 4. Now here I am considering the test point. This is my test point. So this moving point is my test point. To the right of this moving test point, the total number of poles and zeros are 3. Which is an odd number. So, to the left of s is equal to minus 4 will be a part of the root locus. So, this is the procedure we can determine the root locus branches on the root locus. Find out the root locus branches on the root locus. 3. So, to find asymptotes and centroid. And this is step number 3. So calculate the centroid. So the expression of the centroid is centroid is equal sum of fours minus sum of zeros, sum of fours minus sum of zeros divided by n minus m. Now here, given that the number of poles, given that the number of poles n is equal to 3 and number of zeros m is equal to 0, and the total number of zeros are 0 and total number of poles are 3, and the sum of poles minus sum of zeros, and n is the number of poles and small m is the number of zeros. Now here, the what are the poles? S is equal to 0, S is equal to minus 2, and S is equal to minus 4 are the poles. Sum of poles, there are 0 minus 0 plus minus 2 plus into minus minus plus minus 4 plus into minus 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 4, and this is sum of poles minus sum of zeros. Now here, there is no zeros in this example, there is no zeros. So divided by number of poles, what are the total number of poles? 3 minus number of zeros. What are the total number of zeros? There is no zeros here. 0. So that is equal 0 minus 2 minus 4 minus 0 minus 6 divided by 3. So minus 6 divided by 3 minus 2. The centroid is minus 2. So locate the centroid. Mark the centroid on the real axis. Locate the centroid values on the real axis. And this is a graph sheet. In that graph sheet, mark the centroid value. So what is the centroid value? S is equal to minus 2. S is equal to minus 2 is the centroid. And highlight the centroid in graph sheet. This is centroid. Centroid is equal to minus 2. Next, calculate asymptotes, angles of asymptotes. So we know that the basic expression of the angles of asymptotes plus or minus 180 degrees into 2q plus 1 divided by 2q plus 1 divided by n minus m. Here n is equal to number of poles, n is equal to 3, and number of zeros, m is equal to zeros. And substitute q is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. So q is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, n minus m, where q is equal 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on, n minus m minus 1. So what is the n? N is equal to 3. 3, m is equal to 0, 3 minus 0, 3 minus 1, 3 minus 1, 2. So therefore, the range of the q is equal to 0, 1, 2, where q is equal to 0, 1, and 2. Now substitute q is equal to 0, q is equal to 1, and q is equal to 2 in this expression. Find out the angle of asymptotes. So first substitute, if q is equal to 0, then angle of asymptote, angle of asymptotes plus or minus 180 degrees, plus or minus 180 degrees, q is equal to 0. 0 plus 1, 1, plus or minus 180 degrees by 3 minus 0, 3. So plus or minus 180 degrees divided by 3, plus or minus 60 degrees. And this is first angle of asymptotes. Next, if q is equal to 1, if q is equal to 1, then the angle of asymptotes is equal plus or minus 180 degrees into q is equal to 1. 2 plus 1, 3 divided by number of poles minus number of zeros, 3. Numerator and denominator 3 is cancelled. We get plus or minus 180 degrees. And this is second angle of asymptote. And next substitute, if q is equal to 2, then angle of asymptote is equal plus or minus 180 degrees plus or minus 180 degrees into 2 into 2 4 plus 1 5 divided by 3 and 360 6 into 5 30 plus or minus 300 degrees plus or minus 300 degrees or minus or plus 60 degrees and what is total angle 360 degrees so plus or minus 300 degrees are in the reverse direction minus or plus 60 degrees so these are the angles of asymptotes using protractor measure plus 60 degrees measure plus 180 degrees and measure plus 300 degrees in normal graph sheet in ordinary graph sheet this is the centroid centroid is the center point measure angles of asymptotes now here what are the angles of asymptotes q is equal to 0 plus 60 degrees that is first angle of asymptote if q is equal to 1 then second angle of asymptote is plus 180 degrees and if q is equal to 2 and third angle of asymptote is plus 300 degrees so using protractor centroid is the center point measure angle of asymptotes plus 60 degrees plus 180 degrees plus 300 degrees so first measure plus 60 degrees and this is plus 60 degrees highlight the point plus 60 degrees highlight the point and plus 180 degrees plus 180 degrees mean on the negative real axis next plus 300 degrees so the 180 degrees plus 120 degrees are in reverse direction measure minus 60 degrees and this protractor is arranged in reverse direction this protractor is arranged in reverse direction so measure minus 60 degrees in this direction or in this direction 180 degrees plus 120 degrees so both are same and this is minus 60 degrees highlight that point These are angles of asymptotes. These are asymptote curves. Asymptote curves. Next up, to find the breakaway and break-in points. Step number 4, to determine breakaway points and break-in points. Step number 4, to determine breakaway and break-in points. So what is the definition of the breakaway or breaking point? If there exists a real axis root locus branch between two open loop poles, then there will be a breakaway point in between these two open loop poles. That is the breakaway point. And what is the breaking point? If there exists a real axis root locus branch between two open loop zeros, then there will be a breaking point in between these two open loop zeros. And what is breakaway or breaking point? If there is a root locus on the real axis between a pole and zeros, then there may be or may not be a breakaway point or breaking point. So that is the meaning of breakaway and breaking points. So calculate breakaway and breaking points. The procedure of we can determine breakaway and breaking point. First calculate the closed loop transfer function. First determine the closed loop transfer function. The closed loop transfer function is equal to C of S by R of S is equal G of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. Now we are the unity feedback system. The feedback element H of S is equal to 0. Therefore, G of S by 1 plus G of S into H of S. And given that, what is the open loop transfer function? G of S is equal to K by S into S plus 2 into S plus 3, and substitute G of S value into here, we get the resultant expression, the closed loop transfer function, K divided by S into S plus 2 into S plus 4 plus K. So this equation is called as closed loop transfer function of the system. So in this closed loop transfer function, determine the characteristic equation of the system. The denominator polynomial is called as characteristic equation. So therefore, the characteristic equation is, denominator polynomial is the characteristic equation of the system, that is S into S plus 2 into S plus 4 plus K is equal to 0. S plus 4 is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation of the system. So first calculate characteristic equation of the system. Characteristic equation of the system from the given open loop transfer function. The characteristic equation is S into S plus 2 into S plus 4 plus K. So multiplying S into S plus 2 into S plus 4, we get S cube plus 6S square plus 8S plus K is equal to 0. From this equation, the system gain K is equal minus of S cube plus 6S square plus 8S. So this is the constant gain K. Differentiating this equation, this K with respect to S, and equating 0, we get S values. So first differentiating K with respect to S, dK by dS minus of differentiating this equation with respect to S, 3S square plus 12S plus 8, and equating 0, we get 3s square plus 12s plus 8 is equal to 0. Find out the roots of this equation. The roots of this equation is, second order equation is, minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. Ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation. The characteristic equation formula is, roots of the characteristic equation is minus b plus or minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. So using this equation, find out the roots. S is equal. Now here b value is 12 minus 12 plus or minus square root of b square. 12 square minus 4. A value is 3. C value is 8. Divided by 2a. 2 into 3. So find out the reducing this RHS term, we get the roots are minus 0.845 and minus 3.154. So these are the roots of this characteristic equation, and substitute this S values into this equation, we get K value. If the K value must be positive and real, there will be a breakaway or breaking point. If the K value is not equal to real and imaginary part, there is no breakaway or breaking point. So check it, K value must be positive and real. So first substitute S is equal to minus 0.854 value into minus 0.854 value into this equation. When S is equal to minus 0.845 in this equation substitute, K is equal minus of minus 0.8545 whole cube plus 6 into minus 0.845 whole square plus 8 into minus 0.85845, and reducing this value we get k is equal to 3.08. So k is equal to 3.08 is the positive and real value. Since here k is positive and real, S is equal to minus 0.845 is a actual breakaway point. S is equal to minus 0.845 is a actual breakaway point. So in the graph sheet, S is equal to 0 pole, and this is S is equal to minus 4, minus 2 pole, and this is S is equal to minus 1. Now here, what is S value? S is equal to minus 0.845. This is S is equal to minus 0.845. So this S is equal to minus 0.845 is present exit between S is equal to 0 pole and S is equal to minus 2 pole. So now here breakaway point is present. So what is the definition of the breakaway point? If there exists a real axis root locus branch between two open loop poles, then there will be a breakaway point in between these two poles. Now here k is equal 3.08 must be a positive and real value when s is equal to minus 0.845, that s is equal to minus 0.854 is between two poles. So there is a breakaway point between s is equal to 0 and s is equal to minus 2 pole, and this is the breakaway point. This is breakaway point. Next, another value of S. What is another value of S here? The another value of S is equal to minus 3.154. When S is equal to minus 3.154 and substitute this S is equal to minus 3.154 value into this equation, then K is equal to minus of minus 3.154 whole cube plus 6 into minus 3.154 whole square plus 8 into minus 3.154. And reducing RHS term of this equation, we get K is equal to minus 3.08. Now here the K value is negative. The K value is negative when S is equal to minus 3.154. So this is not actual breakaway point or breaking point. This is not a actual breakaway point or breaking point. Now here only one breakaway point. That breakaway point exists between S is equal to 0 pole and S is equal to minus 2 pole. That breakaway point is marked on graph sheet. And this is the breakaway point. That is step number 4. Next, step number 5. Step 5. So, to determine angle of departure and angle of arrival. Step number 5, to find angle of departure and angle of arrival. Angle of arrival. So now here from the given open loop transfer function, there is no complex poles and there is no complex zeros. We need not find angle of departure and angle of arrival here. Now here from the given open loop transfer function, the poles are S is equal to 0 and S is equal to minus 2, S is equal to minus 4. There is no complex poles. And from the given open loop transfer function, there is no zeros. There is no complex zeros. From the given transfer function, there is no complex force and there is no complex zeros. So because of that, here we need not calculate angle of departure and angle of arrival. Next, step number 6. And the step number 6 is to find the crossing point. To find crossing point of imaginary axis. Crossing point of imaginary axis. How to calculate the crossing point of imaginary axis in the characteristic equation? What is the characteristic equation of the given open loop transfer function? The characteristic equation S cube plus 6 S square plus 8 S plus K is equal to 0 is the characteristic equation. In this equation, substitute S is equal to j omega. So we know that the characteristic equation of the open loop transfer function is S cube plus 6s square plus 8s plus k is equal to 0, and substitute S is equal to j omega. In this equation, we get j omega whole cube plus 6 into j omega whole square plus 8 into j omega plus k is equal to 0. So j cube is minus j omega cube, j square value is minus 1 minus 6 omega square plus j 8 omega plus k is equal to 0. So equating on both sides, real parts and imaginary part. First, equating imaginary part on both sides. On LHS side, the imaginary part is minus omega cube plus 8 omega. On RHS side, the imaginary part is 0. So reducing this equation, omega cube is equal 8 omega, and omega square is on both sides, one omega is cancelled, omega square is equal to 8, and omega is equal plus or minus square root of 8. So plus or minus square root of 8 is plus or minus 2.8. Okay, equating on both sides real part, we get omega is equal to 2.8. And equating on both sides real parts, on LHS side, what is the real part? And the real part is minus 6 omega square plus k. On RHS side, the real part is 0, so therefore k is equal to 6 omega square. Now here omega is equal to 2.8, and substitute omega square is equal to 8 here, 6 into 8. The system gain k is equal to 48. The system gain k is equal to 48. So equating on both sides, imaginary part, we get frequency omega is equal to plus or minus 2.8. And equating imaginary real part on both sides, we get this constant gain or the system gain k is equal to 48. And substitute this omega value into s is equal to j omega, we get crossing point on the imaginary axis. And substitute this s is equal to plus or minus 2.8 into s is equal to j omega. The crossing point of root locus is the crossing point of root locus is plus or minus j 2.8, plus or minus j 2.8. In an ordinary graph sheet, mark plus or minus j 2.8. So this is the plus j omega axis and this is minus j omega axis. Now here what is the crossing point? Plus j 2.8, minus j 2.8. So this is plus j 2.8 mean this is, and this is plus j 2.8. And this is negative imaginary axis. And this is minus j 2.8, and this is minus j 2.8, and this is the breakaway point, and these two are the crossing point on the imaginary axis. These two are the crossing point on the imaginary axis. So using these three points, connect a smooth curve. Using these three points, connect a smooth curve. So using these three points, connect a smooth curve. So this is the root locus of the given open loop transfer function.